During the 2023 Paris Air Show, many were taken aback by United Airlines' surprise announcement regarding the engines to power its future A321neo family fleet, an order consisting of 70 A321neo and 50 A321XLR aircraft. The carrier sided with Pratt and Whitney geared turbofan or GTF engines, more specifically the PW1000G. Given Pratt & Whitney's challenges at the time, many were surprised that United didn't opt for the competing CFM Leap-1A for its A321neo fleet. 1 year and many new issues later, the situation is even worse with the GTF engines. So, for today's video, let's take a look at why United sided with Pratt & Whitney rather than CFM. There are many reasons why United should have gone with CFM. United's large fleet of Boeing 737 MAX aircraft is powered by CFM LEAP engines. Thus, in terms of streamlining engine maintenance, training, and parts, CFM would have made a lot of sense for the A321neo aircraft. And then there are the issues that make the PW option less attractive. There are no questions about whether Pratt & Whitney has had a difficult time with its GTF family. Recently, a report by Flight Global indicated that 12% of GTF-powered A320neos were grounded, while an even larger 14% of A220 jets powered by the engine are currently idle. Pratt & Whitney's president and chief executive Chris Calio commented about the number of aircraft that are grounded for engine issues, saying, "I'm not going to get into the specific numbers. When you look at the extended turnaround time that we've talked about, engines coming off aircraft today are going to have to wait a bit until they do get inducted." Sadly, the issues have left their mark with some operators. The Indian airline Go First claimed that the manufacturer and the GTF's issues were directly responsible for the airline's 2023 bankruptcy declaration. Another carrier used more vivid language to categorize their issues with Pratt & Whitney, with Air Astana's CEO calling their engine issues a quote-unquote chronic illness. While supply chain issues are the main problem for the company now, things were far worse a year ago. Pratt & Whitney's parent company, RTX, stated in its Q2 earnings report that a rare condition in powder metal used to manufacture certain engine parts will require accelerated fleet inspection for certain Pratt & Whitney engines. While it was noted that this did not impact engines currently being produced, RTX acknowledged that a significant portion of the PW1100G-JM engine fleet, which powers the A320neo, would require accelerated removals and inspections, including approximately 200 accelerated removals by mid-September of 2023. In April 2024, Flight Global reported that a third of jets with PW-GTF engines were sitting idle due to recalls. The engine, built without defects, is itself performing well, with an impressive 99% dispatch reliability. The problem, however, has arisen due to the supply chain disconnectivity with sourcing of parts, materials, and maintenance slots. These have all presented challenges for PW. To understand why United chose to make such a curious play in the face of evidence in favor of the competition, it's crucial to analyze the pros and cons of both engines for the carrier. First, United does have experience and a long-standing relationship with Pratt & Whitney engines. Power plants from this manufacturer have powered 777, 767, and 757 aircraft within the airline's fleet. While Pratt & Whitney-powered 757s have since been retired, it can be argued that the long-standing relationship with the manufacturer could have motivated the decision to power their A321neos with the GTF engine. Going even further back, you might be interested to know that United Airlines and Pratt & Whitney were essentially one company along with Boeing. Pratt & Whitney was founded in 1925, and in 1929, the company was merged with Boeing and others to form the United Aircraft and Transport Corporation, or UATC. The carrier we know today as United Airlines stems from UATC. This separation was thanks to the 1934 Airmail Act, which declared that airplane manufacturers must be separated from airline operators. While the two companies have this shared history, it's doubtful that this was an influencing factor. Nonetheless, it establishes the fact that a close relationship has existed over the decades. Despite the relationship and many other United Airlines aircraft using Pratt & Whitney power plants, the aforementioned Leap-1A from CFM would be a far better choice from a maintenance perspective to power the airline's A321neos. As we already noted, the airline would be able to maintain fleet commonality and streamline costs. Furthermore, the airline wouldn't have to worry about the supply chain problems plaguing Pratt & Whitney and its geared turbofans, even if these are hoped to be resolved in the next 12 months or so. So what puts the GTF engines above their Leap rivals? Well, if operating at performance standards, the PW1000 family engine does maintain a slight operational advantage for United. This is one thing that could have influenced the decision. The Pratt & Whitney engine has a higher bypass ratio than the Leap-1A, at 12.5 to 1, compared to the CFM's 11 to 1. Additionally, at just over 6,300 pounds, the GTF engine weighs slightly less than the Leap, which weighs over 6,600 pounds. While these discrepancies may seem minute, the Pratt & Whitney made engines are the most efficient and sustainable propulsion system for single-aisle aircraft. As such, United can realize some significant cost savings with this pick. According to Pratt & Whitney and its marketing material, the Pratt & Whitney GTF engine is the only geared propulsion system delivering industry-leading fuel efficiency and sustainability benefits. Our geared fan has fundamentally changed how more sustainable propulsion works. The promotional message continues saying, "Having quickly become the foundation of our industry's future, our gear system has reset the bar on the good that all other advanced technologies can deliver, from advanced materials to hybrid electric systems to sustainable aviation fuels." Unfortunately, while engine price could have been a factor, we'll never know how much United paid for the engines powering its A321neos. Additionally, we'll never know how much United would have paid for the equivalent CFM Leap power plants. Thus, despite United's curious decision, specific reasons why the selection may have made sense for the American carrier can be identified. At the time of this video's production, Planespotters.net lists 3 out of 15 United Airlines A321neos as being parked or undergoing maintenance. As per Flight Radar 24 data, these aircraft haven't flown since the end of August. No, it's not a terribly long amount of time to be parked, but at the same time, it's not exactly what you'd expect for nearly brand new aircraft. And so, what do you think about United's decision to go with Pratt & Whitney's geared turbofan engines over the offering from CFM? Was the airline being overly optimistic about Pratt & Whitney's ability to resolve its issues? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.